Hello, all you lovely people in internet land. It's AC for Game Life Balance Australia, and I just got one of my boxes from my latest Japanese trip. Now, I posted this via C-mail, so it took, I'm going to say about 7 weeks, which isn't too bad, 7 weeks is certainly acceptable. The box came in quite a state. It's very creased, no matter how much tape I put around it. The box actually split open right here. I don't know if I've lost anything, and truth be told, I can't even remember what's in this box. So this is going to be a surprise for everyone involved. I'll just pop that over here. Here we go. So it's going to be one long take. Even if I fuck up or something like that, that's all right. We'll just keep going on. So what did I get? The contents of this box were mostly from the Guma part of my trip, when I was staying with my wife and baby in a little apartment. We had a lovely time. I went to lots of book-offs and lots of hard-offs, and I found some surprising things there. So, and not all of it is going to be game-related. Oh, but that's not good, is it? All right, well, first of all, let's get rid of the harmful tape. Hopefully won't scratch my leather chair. Alright, we'll put that over there. Alright, so first of all, I have a Coco Ichiban calendar for 2017. I have two of these. I love Coco Ichiban. So maybe I'll have this one at work, perhaps. But it's kind of cool that I have two of those. So I can look at Coco Ichiban curry every day of the week. Okay, I'll bring this brutish fellow out. We have a Mario Maker figure. Like a giant, I think it was a prize. Interestingly, this one is actually made by Taito, it says on the back here. And, it's posable, which is cool. There's lots of screws in the back here, so it's not like a fully solid model. It's quite a little bit flimsy, but I just really like the look of it, and I love Mario Maker. So I saw this for about like 1,000 yen, 10 bucks. So I thought, you know what, sure. Sure, I should totally get Mario Maker Mario. There we go. Put him off to the side there. He stands up quite well. Yeah, a lot of this is going to be non-game related. Just cause. Because why not? What do I have here? I have a Swallows glass. Baseball team, the Yakult Swallows, it's the Tokyo team, the second Tokyo team. They're, I was never really that into baseball. However, I decided that while I was living over there, I should, maybe support one team, we'll go to a couple of games. And I decided to follow the Swallows just because they sounded funny. That's it. That's the only reason I had. And I saw this for like 50 yen, 50 cents or so, that would be. Actually, my wife saw it and said, you should totally get that. So that's like my fun little little glass there. Take the price tag off it later. Oh, yes. Okay. We have two Sailor Moon wine glasses. So I saw these and joked, haha, look at this, and my wife is actually a bit of a Sailor Moon fan. So hopefully these survived the trip. Looks like they did. Yep, we have a tuxedo mask. And we have Sailor Moon. There we go. They don't necessarily have to be for wine, obviously. If it's for kids, you wouldn't say it's for wine. They're just, nice glasses, pair glass. So one for me, one for my wife. And my wife actually tricked me into cosplaying as tuxedo mask before. When we had to go to a dress-up party or something back in Japan. I had no idea who he was back then. I'd never seen Sailor Moon. Okay, it's good to see that those survived the trip. So this is the Pokemon roulette dice that we got with a Christmas cake. And we just thought it was kind of cool. Like, it came with a board game on top of, like, the only cake we could get at Christmas, because Christmas cake is not like the fruit and nut cake we have in the Western world. It's like, you know, a cream sponge cake with strawberries and fruit on top. It was a nice cake, but since we didn't order one beforehand, we had to go to a department store, and the only one they had left is Pokemon cake, and it came with a board game. The board game was kind of fun. So I decided to save that, because it was kind of fun. Kind of cool. We have a Sega Saturn controller, analog stick. It seemed to survive the trip quite nicely. This is mainly used for Nights into Dreams. And the analog stick really helps for that better than the D-pad. Honestly, like, I already have one of these, but it's always good to have a spare. I'm all about having a backup. So, and it was only like, you know, maybe 200 yen or 300 yen. I wouldn't have paid any more for it than that, certainly. Right. Ooh. This is Le Mysterious City. The Mysterious Cities of Gold, which I got off Yahoo Auction. This is the French version, which is similar to the English version. It's a record, it's an LP, so it's very hard to come across Mysterious Cities of Gold stuff, so I saw that for like 2,000 yen or something, so I decided to jump on that, and my wife kindly arranged for it to be shipped. Yeah, I really don't remember what half this stuff is. I had a stopper for a walking stick, because I need walking sticks sometimes. Alright, here we go. Let's look at some games. Very casually today. I have box isn't in great condition, but a Pocket Station, which is actually the original PlayStation handheld from Sony. So I'll just pop that open there, and there is the unit itself. It plugs into the memory port of a PS1. And it's kind of like the FMU, the VMU, whatever, visual memory unit for a Dreamcast. Possibly not even as good as that. I don't remember there being... It doesn't have a lot of compatibility, but I think there's like a Final Fantasy game that it works with. It's 7 or 8 from memory. That's kind of cool that I found a box one, though. It was quite cheap from memory as well. I wouldn't really spend a lot of money on any of this stuff unless I really wanted it. We have Power Stone, reportedly a good game. Capcom game for the Dreamcast. I've been after a copy of that for a while. Oh, yes. Very nice. This is Revolutionary Girl Utena for the Sega Saturn. And this even comes with an art book. It's a visual novel for the most part, I think, but I have a soft spot for this anime, it's fair to say. Oh, man, I can't even remember what half this stuff is. Just a Pokemon Yellow. Whoops. I think I have a few of those. I don't know why I have them. Now, this is a complete in box. Hopefully complete in box, or at least box with cartridge. It might not have the manual. For Gradius, the Konami vertical shooter. For Famicom, great game. And it's obviously, you know, not still in its shrink wrap from the 1980s. Someone shrink wrapped it again. They love doing that in Japan. Dungeon Explorer for the PC Engine. Cool. And some Famicom games. Star Soldier. And Ninja Dragon, which is Bad Dudes. It just has a slightly different name. I think its full title is Bad Dudes versus Dragon Ninja or something like that. That's how I remember it. Is it Bad Dudes? Man, I'm going to look like an absolute idiot. I'm actually very tired today. But the box came and I couldn't help but open it for you all. Because reasons. Good reasons. Right, this bag. So the reason it's good to bag everything up is in case there is a hole in the box, hopefully it won't kind of, you know, if it's all in a bag, the bag will hopefully be bigger than the hole and it won't slip out. But in this one, we have a Super Famicom game, Mickey's Magical Adventure, that would translate into, which is a Capcom game. Put that over there. Gun Barrel, or Gun Baru, which is a Hot Shot. Oh no, not Hot Shots. Hot Shots is the golf game. Point Blank is what we call it over here. That's right. Yes. I quite like these games actually because they're not, you know, I have the Namco gun, but they're not like boom, 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 killing people. It's just target practice and stuff like that with funny. Funny kind of targets you can shoot at. Not necessarily a violent game, which is appreciated. A really faded Pokemon Yellow? I don't even know why I had so many of these. I think maybe I forgot that I had one or something like that. And Starry for Game Boy Advance. Apparently a good platformer. Played it a little bit. And we have Iron Maiden the Second. The first was on Sega Saturn, I think. Yeah. Yes, it was. It's all up here. And this is the PlayStation 2 sequel. So it's basically going to be a visual novel for the most part. Looks like, from the back, it looks like it's based off that alternate reality that Shinji has a vision of at the end of Genesis 13 or episode 26. And Gitaru Man. I have no idea what this game is. It might be a rhythm-based thing or a shooter. I don't know. It just, it was like 100 yen and it looked funky. I don't know if it's ever been released in the West or not. And I also have in here, ooh, look at that. You probably can't see this very well on camera because the figure's in shrink wrap there, but it is Persona 4, Chie, best girl. I don't usually say that very often, but that was very cheap. That was like 200 yen or something like that. And, I don't know, I might sell some of this stuff on, try and recoup some of the cost of buying all this stuff and sending it back to myself. What else we got? Oh, CDs for the most part. We have the American McGee's Alice soundtrack, which is a gothic sort of sound, which I really liked when I played the game. The game I did find okay, but I think the soundtrack was probably a big part of that. So it's cool that I got that. I have the Splatoon original soundtrack. And it's just fun. I like the music from Splatoon. It's very upbeat, you know, it's very action-y. So that's pretty cool. Reframe of Evangelion, which is just basically a best of soundtrack. Evangelion 2.0, which is very hard to say because it's mostly a black cover there. But I really like the Evangelion music from the TV shows and the movies. And I got Persona 4 original soundtrack. Now, Australia and Europe, I'm not sure about America and Japan, got the soundtrack included in the game, but it wasn't the full soundtrack. It was kind of like a best of, and this is like, you know, basically got 50 tracks between two discs, so it's pretty cool. I quite like the music of Persona 4. Evangelion. I've been after this for a while. This is like basically the end-all, be-all Evangelion soundtrack. It is called Evangelion, Neon Genesis Evangelion S2 Works, which is basically not only every incidental music from the show, it is also basically every kind of version of that, like with high tempo, low tempo, fast, slow. It's basically everything. And you know, you wouldn't listen to all of that necessarily. I mean, I might, because I'm a really big Evangelion fan. But this is complete in box, which means that you get all the funky... that is meant to be upside down. Soundtracks here. 4 discs. 5 discs. 6 discs. And a bonus disc. What's on the bonus disc? Just bonus disc, okay. A postcard. And... oh god, did they really have to use that image? Hopefully you can't even see that, actually. It's not, it's from the movie. But yeah, it's the track listing here, like... it's just full of different versions of every song. And there is a highly collectible telephone card in here from the Death and Rebirth one there that's never been used. That's pretty cool to find that. So, people in Japan used to, I don't know if it's a big thing anymore, used to collect telephone cards with like their favorite characters and stuff on them. So that's pretty cool. Unfortunately, it smells like the person who used to own this was a bit of a smoker. Smokers are jokers. So I'll just pack all of that back in there now. Yes, there we go. That's cool, I've been after that for a very long time. I've got a lot of stuff. I got a orange GameCube controller. This controller is mounted, but the orange one was never released outside of Australia, unfortunately. And the color's pretty striking. I need to just do basically a swap for a good controller for this one, and then that'll be fine. I was also after one of these for a while. This is a Famicom Hudson controller. You can tell by the honeybee, Hudson honeybee there. And the great thing about this is that, well, number one, it's a bit bigger for my hands, which is always good. And number two, it has got turbo buttons, which is really good for games like Gradius. And the controller is like a little bit longer than the other ones as well. And it also connects to the front, so you can don't have to be right in front of your television next to the Famicom. So that's cool. PlayStation 2 memory card for whatever reason. Mario Party 3 because I hate my friends. Pokemon Stadium, and it's also got the pack with it as well, the for the Game Boy games that you put in there, so you can transfer your Pokemon from your Red and Blue and all that. Speaking of Pokemon Blue, there is the blue one. I think this may have been a send-away in Japan rather than a store-bought. I can't remember. There's some sort of thing where this is basically like the fixed version of the original ones in Japan, which were Red and Green. Dreamcast VMU, which we were talking about before, visual memory unit. I forgot I even bought this. WonderSwan Color One Piece game. For reasons. Mr. Driller, my wife loved this game when I bought it. Starry 2. Now I have both Staris. I think there's a third one as well. And Sonic Advance, the first one. I like the second one a lot better than the first one, to be completely honest. But now I have all of them, which is always good. A GameCube memory unit. It's actual first party. You only ever seem to find the third party ones in Australia, because I'm guessing the first party ones were just really expensive. Game Boy Picross 2. Good game. Remind a bit of Picross. Made in Wario. I do like the Wario series. They're a lot of fun. Now this is the Game Boy Player. Always good to have a couple of extra ones of those, because sometimes you find the base unit but not the disc that goes with it for the GameCube. Pre-Pre? Not a great game, actually. It's an alright Game Boy game, I suppose. And Star Sweep, which I think is a puzzle game for Game Boy. Bit of fun. Complete in-box pocket bass fishing, because I think it was 100 yen or something, and I thought, I'll just give it a go. Why not? It's not as bad as I thought it was going to be when I tested it out. It's kind of cool. I like complete in-box Game Boy stuff, because you don't come across them very much. Punch-Out? It's a platformer. I can't quite remember what this game's about. It's not bad, though, that one. Mr. Driller 2. And we have, look at that, a Pokemon Mini. Even comes with the little game cartridges in there as well, and the instruction manuals. That's kind of cool, little handheld I didn't have before. Wow, man, I got a lot of stuff. It's just a cup. There you go, which you can use for camping trips and the like. It's kind of cool. I like to have those. A little mini arcade thing which we won in a UFO machine skill tester type of thing. It purports 108 games, which half of them are going to be the same and the other half won't work. But I just thought it was fun. I like the kind of little look of this thing. So, I'll just turn it on and find out what kind of games they have for it, I guess. I just like the, I could put it on top of my other arcade, actually. Well, there's the instruction manual for it. These look kind of pre-Famicom era games. my Vita case, which I shipped back to myself because I found a better one. Clefairy. That is Clefairy? I think so. Fan from some sort of Pokemon event or giveaway or something like that, it was like 20 yen, 20 cents or something. I thought, oh, that's kind of cool, I guess. All right. Keep moving ever forward. Oh, they arrived intact. Perfect. These are Lum and Ataru Maraboshi from Urusei Yatsura. I'm a big fan of Lum. It's Lum there, and there. And this is a pear mug. So these, the wedding versions, also appeared on my actual wedding invitation too. So they were given to us by my wife's aunt and uncle for Christmas. It's kind of cool. Right, now, I'm not going to go through all of this, but I've already done a video on this. This is actually all the Persona 4 merchandise that I got over there. If you want to cosplay as Chia, there's the badges that she wears and the eye masks and everything. Oh, and a pair of 3D glasses. This is really weird because nothing is in 3D. and it's freaking my brain out. If you want to know about all the Persona 4 stuff that I got this whole bag for like 600, 700 yen, like 6, 10 bucks. Watch that video. I really don't want to go, have to go through all that again. Now, I did actually get one of these. A friend of mine and a friend of the show was telling me that these were kind of rare outside of Japan. This color variant, I think, only existed there. And it came with the Game Boy Player. Now, it's actually kind of a bit broken on the back, so it's not worth sending to anyone, unfortunately. And it's really quite badly damaged on top and stuff like that. But I thought, you know, I have no idea, well, it's really dirty in there, if it works or not, but I might be able to do like a, maybe clean it up, maybe patch up the back and stuff like that. So thanks to Matt for pointing me in the right direction. I probably should have sent it to him, to be honest. But he wouldn't have wanted this one because, yeah, it's damaged, unfortunately. But I was there on one of my last trips to Hardoff, and it was still there for like 300 yen, $3 for this. You know, I got this for $1. So if I can get it to work, because last time I tried to plug it in, I don't think it worked. That's good. If not, well, I'll just do a case swap after I repair the grill on the back and stuff like that. But yeah, kind of cool. A Dreamcast mic, which is, I think, is only useful for like one or two games, and one of them is Mario Party, so. Oops. Gemini. Cut. It's from the Persona 4 stuff. An Evangelion glass. I think I'm going to give this one. I have two of the other ones from this series as well. It's got Evangelion Unit 1. I think it's from the reboot movies. I think I'm going to give this one to Eric because he always, every time he comes around here, he drinks out of one of the Ava ones. So I thought I'd give him his own. Very nice of me. Now, it's mostly just games left. Here's the rest of that. Pieces, Mokoro and Pikachu and Kitten or Kaiten or Fire, I don't know. You probably can't see those from there. I'm not a Pokemon sort of person, to be honest. So I got this as well, or rather my wife got this for me, which is the, it's a boxed Neon Genesis PlayStation 2 pack, and it comes with all of this really funky, cool stuff. So it comes with like a pen and a phone strap, a notebook, some of the Cubula Angel. I can't remember Romeo. I can't remember which angel that is off the top of my head, which is terrible. Fourth or fifth angel or something like that. And I thought this is so awesome. It was only like 1,000 yen or something like that. And I love Evangelion. And of course it is a pachinko game. You know, like a gambling slot machine-esque sort of thing. Why you would need to put all that in a special edition, I have no idea. There are actually some pretty good, there's like a PlayStation 2. It's almost like a Super Smash Brothers game with Evangelion and Angels, which I managed to get for like 500 yen, and that's worth doing a video of. I might do a video of this one, just because I don't know, I hate everyone. It's always a good reason. If people want to see it, I'll show it to them. Right. Whoa, there goes the box. There's still stuff in there too. Right. So, what have we got here? Well, we got Sonic Jam, which is a compilation, because there's no real Sonic game, unless you count like Sonic Racing for the Saturn, and this is just like a compilation of the first three, and Sonic and Knuckles, I think, for the Mega Drive. There's my Saturn pile. Saturn Bomberman Fighter. Not sure whether that's the good one or not. I think I have the good one. 1-4 players, so you need the extension. I think to Saturn Bomberman. Not the fight one. But this might be good as well, I can't remember. The other one is a very good version, maybe one of the definitive versions. I hope I have that somewhere. It's probably in the other box if I do have it. I have another box coming from Japan. Snatcher for the Saturn. Of course, in Japanese. X-Men versus Street Fighter. Well, that's cool. You know, I was looking at this lot and thinking I should get it, and I forgot that I actually got it. Brilliant. That's like a surprise for me. I actually did get that game. Okay, good on me, I suppose. Street Fighter Zero versus Sega Saturn. I like fighting games. I'm not good at them, but I like playing them. Shining Wisdom. It's like a little bit of like an RPG or something like that for Saturn. Not sure why I would have gotten that one. Ah, yes, here we go. Only this winter, Christmas Nights into Dreams. Now, I never have any Christmas games to do for the Game Life Balance Australia Christmas special. Now I have one, so hopefully by the end of this year, we will actually get to do this game. We'll make an event of it. Fighters Megamix. Sega game. Basically, what? This is Virtua Fighter? A whole bunch of other characters like that. Didn't have that one. I don't know if it's any good. Dreamcast. Space Channel 5. Been after that one for a while as well. The Japanese cover is all glittery. It's really, really cool. I didn't get many Dreamcast games this time around. The next one I like very much. This pile here is of mostly PC Engine games and PC Engine CD games. I got a PC Engine Duo with the CD that actually works. So I think this is a visual novel. F1 Racing. Man, I don't know what the hell this game is. Probably another visual novel detective story by the look of it. Far East of Eden. This definitely looks like an RPG. I think because these games were only like 100 yen and I was so excited to get a working CD. PC Engine CD that I just went nuts and just bought whatever I could find for it, which was probably the wrong thing to do, but yeah, that's my prerogative. Jukebox 2, the Urusei Yatsura CDs. It's got a whole bunch of what I would classify as B songs from the Urusei Yatsura series. Still, I'm a big fan, a bit of a collector of that. And, oh, I like this one. This is Wonder Boy 3 Monster Lair. So, this is actually a little bit of a departure from the rest of the Monster series, the Wonder Boy series, because it is a horizontal shooter. I think I may have said before that Gradius was a vertical shooter. I was wrong. It's a horizontal shooter. Got those two mixed up. I'll blame that on my tiredness, I think. All right, we're almost done. Oh. Right. Oh yes, we've got a whole bunch of Famicom games in here. I like. First of all, we actually have a boxed Famicom game by Namco. Namco Technologies, probably. It actually comes with the manual, and these come with stickers as well. Now, the cases for the Namco games were quite special because they actually came in clamshells rather than just cardboard boxes. And to be fair, I don't like a lot of the early Namco games, but, you know, Pinball's not a bad game, and there's a little bit of Pac-Man in there, I think, as a reference, so I'm glad I picked that up. Street Fighter are boxed, although there's no insert, it's just the manual and the cart Street Fighter 2 Turbo. I think, usually I don't usually bother getting boxed stuff, but it had the manual, it was only like 100 yen or something like that, so I thought, oh, why not. Super PC Gengen 2, I suppose that would be, or Gengen, whatever his name is in, I get so confused, there's so many different ways to say his name. But, there we go, it's BC Kid in Australia, I think. That's pretty cool, getting a boxed copy of that, and I think it is actually complete. And apparently it's a good game. A lot of these games are actually quite short, but they're a lot of fun. I really appreciate playing these games. Tetris Battle Gaiden. Instead of sending Matt this broken and very, very dirty GameCube, I sent him a boxed copy, Tetris Battle Gaiden, and this is the best Tetris game there is. It's so random, it's great. I think I got a boxed copy, I just sent him a loose card, because even those are kind of getting rare, because I think the Giant Bomb website touted it, and then the prices online skyrocketed, but they're very common in Japan still. And my one is very, very yellowed, so I bought one of these, and I'll probably sell on the other yellowing cart. Dorabo-chan, I have no idea who this is or what this game is about. I've never played it. I couldn't test any of these games because I didn't have a Super Famicom with me over in Japan. Although I could have bought one for a dollar, I guess. Final Fight 2. The finalist of fights? I don't know. Seems like a weird sequel. I have number 3 or Tough or whatever it's called. Oh, here we go. Rockman 7. I've never played this before. Love the Rockman series. I am terrible at them. But I do love playing them. I love a good platformer, even if it's insanely difficult. And we have a whole bunch of Famicom games. We have Road Fighter by Konami. Oh, yes. Tiande, which is Samurai Pizza Cats. I was after this for a while. It's a great platformer. It is difficult to get because it was never released outside of Japan and people remember Samurai Pizza Cats. I want to do a video of that one stage with my wife, hopefully, for Super Retro Happy Time, which is a series that we sometimes do. It's been put on hold because we have a baby. Sky Destroyer, title game. Goemon 2, which is a Konami game. I think some of the Goemon games are quite good. It's amazing, I forgot that I even had a lot of these. Kamen Rider, Bandai game. I don't know if that's any good or not. Sunsoft Barcode World. I think there is actually an add-on for this that I needed and didn't get, so that might be a junk purchase. Dragon Spirit. I think I have this for PC Engine as well. Namco game. Mag Max, which looks like some sort of shooter. Nichibutsu. I'm not sure of that company, actually. There we go, though. Palmon by Irem. Apparently this is actually a pretty good platformer. So I can't wait to play that. Once again, I haven't tested any of these games. Juju. Can't read that kanji, but it is a TAD game. It's licensed by Taito, though, so I love Taito. Taito's probably one of my favorite companies. Getsuhu Maden. Konami, 1987. Don't know anything about that game. Could be good. B-Wings. Once again, I think it's just a shooter. I like a good shooter myself. Jarvis. This is interesting because it actually has a save function where you can remove the battery and replace it. This one's probably dead, and probably very long dead at that. But it's 2 megabytes. Massive. I don't even know what this game is. The hiragana is too small for me to translate. There we go, and I'm lazy. Palmon 2. Hopefully the first one's good, and hopefully the second one's even better. Now, Spelunker 2. What I like about the Irem carts is that some of them have like a red LED which will turn on when you plug the cart in. Which is good because the Famicom, the original one, or any of the other subsequent ones, other than one version of the Sharp Twin Famicom, have a power on light. And, Aramajiro? Funky writing. I don't know. Not sure about this, but looked funny enough. So why not? Okay, last. The last bag, here we go. I have no idea, this has probably been running like a really, really long video today. If you made it this far, I'm impressed. Man, there's a lot of stuff here. Oh, come on. Here we go. Inuyasha. For the PlayStation 1. That's cool. Probably not a good game, but you know, play it anyway. Shaman King. Looks just like a weird-ass fighting game. Weird-ass fighting games can be good. I'll happily chat about a weird fighting game. This one I got for my wife because she likes it. This is IQ, Intelligence Cube, which is like the one where you dodge all the cubes that are coming for you. It's a puzzle game. I don't even know why I got this, really. It's Iron Maiden. The first girlfriend game, except not for Saturn, it is for the PlayStation 1. It comes with a whole bunch of stuff in here, so who knows. Maybe that's why I got it. Maybe it's got something good in there that's the reason I got it. Who knows? I can never even tell what past Andrew is thinking sometimes. But Rapper the Rapper seems to be in really good condition. It's not really difficult to get, but it can be sort of difficult. This is great because it's in English, even the Japanese version. And it comes with the town map. Whee! I always remember liking that. I wasn't particularly good at it, but I did like a bit of Rapper the Rapper back in the day. Breath of Fire, once again, it's an RPG. Not really sure why I got this one, but anyway, there you go. I must have just been out shopping and excited. Megatudo 2096. This looks like a Virtualon by Sega ripoff. It's like two big robots fighting each other, so see what that's like. And a Lupin the Third Castle of Cagliostro game. Didn't even know this existed. I don't have high hopes for that, but I'd like to give it a go, you know? Gashubed. Once again, I think it's a fighting game. I think this is an anime of some description. I am not familiar with it, but hey, whatever. Huh. You know what's really weird about me is that I accidentally got this game twice. Because I just collect whatever Neon Genesis game I could find. And this is the one I was talking about before, and I think I only must have become aware of it halfway through my trip and didn't think I had it, but it turned out I had actually already bought a copy of it. Yeah, Battle Orchestra, Neon Genesis Evangelion. I am an idiot. But, you know, having two copies of this, not a bad thing. The other one I have actually comes with a manual, so maybe I can sell this one on. And last, and probably least, we have the Neon Genesis Evangelion Decade Memorial Box for PSP. And it comes with a game. Another case, this one is called. I don't think I have that one. and Neon Genesis Evangelion UMD video, which is of the film, I think. The 90s death. So it's a... I think this is probably End of Evangelion from memory. It actually comes on two UMDs. Sony Pussy format. I hate that format so much. But the box is cool. And I love Neon Genesis, so that's probably why I got those. And it was cheap. So there you have it. There's some good stuff there. I'm probably going to sell some of this stuff on. But in any case, I will be right to play a lot of games for years to come. So thank you very much for watching. I am AC for Game Life Balance Australia. I am very tired. Very tired.
Liquid Hot Magma Diver.